Hello one and all. Again welcome to first PUC online classes. Chapter is motion in a plate, lecture number 3. Students, in the previous class we have seen so many types of vectors: polar vector, coincidental vector, orthogonal vector, zero vector, and one more type of vector, unit vector. So many types of vector we have seen. Now in this class let us discuss some types of vectors, especially the position vector and displacement vector, and how to add a given vector and how to multiply a given vector by a real number. This concept we will see in this class. Shall we go? The first concept is the position vector. Position vector. Here position vector means the vector drawing from origin at any instant. What that is? The vector drawing from origin at any instant is called as position vector. To understand the concept of position vector, now we will take a vector. From the vector, if we draw this vector at any instant, that represents position vector. See here, let us see further definition. Then we will go for a different orientation how to represent the given position vector. See here, definition is position vector means the vector drawing from origin. Vector drawing from origin. From origin. At any instant. Is called as position vector. Position vector. Let us understand the position vector. Now students, I will take the origin point. Look at this. This is nothing but the origin point. Shall I call this point as the O? From the O point, if we draw any vector at any instant, for example, shall I draw this vector? This vector from this origin point to this instant. Right? Or if we draw, let us take the one more position. Shall I draw this? This is nothing but O point to origin. If we draw this vector up to this instant. Right? Either you can represent this vector by p, and unit vector is either, right? Either you can represent this vector is nothing but a vector, and the unit vector that is represented by either, because along the x-axis, I cap is the unit vector. Simply unit vector means vector drawing from origin at any instant. Now let us take one more example. Shall I tell you directly how to write? Look at me. The vector p or vector a can be represented. Vector p equal to how much? Vector p equal to modulus of a into I cap. This is nothing but the position vector. Then in the given plane, how to represent the position vector? How to represent a position vector? See here. I will take a plane here. Look at me. This is one plane. Shall I call this? This is x-axis. What are I calling? This is the y-axis. Right. What we are calling, this is nothing but origin. This is nothing but origin. Now, in this plane, consider any particle moving. Any particle moving. See, in this direction, consider in this direction, this particle moving. In this direction. Are you following? In a plane, how to represent position vector? It is very important. See, as students, I will take from this origin. Position vector means the vector drawing from origin. See here, on this motion, let us take this the point, P point I will take, right? The P point has a coordinate x and y, right? What is position vector? Position vector is the vector drawing from origin. Vector drawing from origin. This vector we are calling position vector. I mean, this is the direction of position vector, and position vector can be represented by r here, right? What this is? Vector drawing from origin. Then graphically, how to represent position here? See here, actually what is x? X represent the component of position vector along x axis. Y represent component of position vector along y axis. That's what. Here only I written one component. Here two components are there. Then how to write the position vector generally? Position vector can be represented by r. R equal to which? R equal to x I cap plus how much? Y is I cap. What is meaning of this? The position vector has the component along x axis can be represented by x I cap and the component along y axis can be represented by y z cap. What is I cap and z cap? These are represent unit vector along x axis and y axis. So this is how to represent the position vector. Then how to represent magnitude of the position vector? Here I cap z cap represent unit vector. Their values are 1, right? See here, how to write the magnitude, I mean modulus of position vector. Correctly, modulus of position vector can be represented under root of x square plus y square. I am not putting I square because I square, I equal to 1, j equal to 1. 1 square, 1. I square, 1. J square also, 1. That's why the modulus of position vector can be represented like this. Can be represented like this. Right? This is what? This is nothing but position vector into coordinates along x axis and y axis. Now we'll take position vector also represent in terms of three coordinates. In terms of three Cartesian coordinates also. There you can represent. See here, students. Shall I take? I will take a cube here. Look at me. This is nothing but one cube I will take. Right? Simply I will take this is a cube. This is nothing but origin point. Shall I call this point as the core? Right? This is the x axis. Right? What about this? This is the y axis. Then what about this? This is nothing but the z axis. Right? Along x axis, unit vector is nothing but I cap. I cap. Along y axis, unit vector is nothing but j cap. Along the z axis, unit vector is nothing but the k cap. Right? This is the origin point. See here, what is position vector? I will take here the point, some point I will take here, in this position, P point I will take, in this position, P. What is P here? P represent x, y and z. Right? Points I will take. Position vector means, this is nothing but the origin point. Position vector means the vector drawing from origin. Vector drawing from origin. This vector we are calling position vector. Right? What is x component? X I cap represent component of position vector along x axis. Y z cap represent the position vector along y axis. And z k cap represent component of position vector along z axis. Then here how to represent the position vector? Here I represent r equal to x I cap plus y z cap. But in this case how to represent? In this case the position vector can be represented. Position vector can be represented x I cap plus y z cap plus how much? This is nothing but the position vector along x, y and z axis. Then again modulus of the right. See here, shall I write the modulus of r? Modulus of r in what way can represent modulus? Under root. In x square plus y square because only two components are available. But here three components. How to write? Three components shall I write? X square, y square plus z square. Then students here, how to represent unit vector by taking this compound? Unit vector means their magnitude is 1. In last class, we have represent the unit vector. In what way can we represent the unit vector? See here, in this case, unit vector r equal to modulus of r into r cap. Here, what is r cap? R cap represent unit vector. Already I said that any vector can be represented in terms of unit vector. Then in this case how to represent unit vector? Shall I take here? R cap equal to R divided by how much? Modulus of R. Modulus of R. Right? What is R actually? X I cap plus Y J cap plus Z J cap. Shall I write? X I cap Y J cap plus Z J cap. This is vector R. What is modulus of R? Modulus of R equal to under root how much?
under root of x square y square plus x square.
Right.
Any unit vector. In this case, how to write? In this case, actually, vector r equal to modulus of r into much r cap. Actually, what is r cap again? R cap equal to r divided by modulus of r. Right. What is r actually? X I cap plus y j cap. Similarly, modulus of r here. How much? X square plus y square under root. Like this. I mean, the position vector means vector drawing from a given origin along one axis can be represented like this. Along the two coordinates in a plane can be represented like this. And three dimensional, it can be represented like this. The position vector. After this, let us see the one more type of vector that we are calling displacement vector. We will see now. Displacement vector. Shall we take this? After this, let us see displacement vector. Right, students. Displacement vector. To understand the concept of displacement vector, consider a particle moving in a plane. Shall I take a plane? Students, look at me. How to say? This is nothing but y axis. This we are calling the x axis. X axis, this is the origin. What are we calling? This is nothing but the y axis. Right. In this plane, consider the particle moving. How the particle moving actually? Look at me. In this direction, particle moving. In this direction. The particle moving like this. How? You can take like this also, doesn't matter. In any direction particle can move. In this direction particle can move like this. Right? I will choose any point here. Look at me. Shall I choose any point here? I will take this nothing but the point P. What are the components there? X1 and Y1. Right? I will take another point. What point I will take? I will take this nothing but the point. Shall I take this point? This point is nothing but P dash. What about P dash? P dash is equal to X2Y2. X2 points are taken. See here, now I will take position vector from O to P and position vector from O to P dash. Shall I take here? Look at me. If we draw a vector from this point, this represents position vector. Shall I represent the position vector by R? Position vector by R, right? How to write the position vector then? The position vector can be represented R equal to how much? R equal to x1 I cap plus y1 z cap. x1 I cap plus y1 z cap. What is x1 I cap? Component of position vector R along x axis. Y z cap represents the position of component of position vector along y axis, right? And I cap and j cap represent unit vector along x axis, and unit vector along y axis. Right. Similarly, the particle comes from P to P dash. I will take one more position vector here. Position vector mean, again draw this vector from this point. This becomes position vector. Shall I take this? This is equal to R dash. Correct. What about R dash here? Again one more position vector. How do we represent? R dash equal to x2 I cap plus y2 j cap. Right. Here we know the displacement. What is the displacement? Difference in final position and initial position. This is the final position. This we are calling the initial position. This we are calling the displacement. See how to take the displacement? Simply the displacement is line joining from initial position to final position. Shall I take this one? This is represented by del r. What is the difference between final position and the initial position? Right. Here, how to write? Displacement vector can be represented like this. Displacement vector r dash is equal to how much? This is the r dash minus r. R dash minus r. That is r dash vector minus r vector. Then what is the displacement vector? Displacement vector is the change in position of the vector in a given interval of time. Right? Simply, displacement vector is the change in position of the particle in a given interval of time, or change in position of the vector in a given interval of time. This we are calling the displacement vector here. We know r equal to x I cap plus x1 I cap plus y1 j cap. R dash equal to x2 I cap plus y2 j cap. Then how to write the displacement vector in this case? Look at me. Del r equal to. What is del r here? Del r in r dash. R dash equal to x2 I cap plus y2 j cap. What is r then? R equal to x1 I cap plus y1 j cap. R equal to. Then again, how to write here? Displacement vector. Displacement vector del r equal to x2 minus x1 of I cap. X2 minus x1 of I cap plus how to represent? Y2 minus y1 of how much? J cap. Right? This is what? The displacement vector. Displacement vector in a plane. Simply, displacement vector is the change in position of the vector in a given interval of time. Right? Then here, how to write the magnitude of this resultant vector? Result magnitude of magnitude of the given displacement vector. Shall I write the magnitude in this case? See here, how to write the magnitude mean modulus? Modulus of. What is the modulus directly here? Modulus under root. Under root how much? X2 minus X1 of whole square. Because I square is 1. I equal to 1. I square also 1. Plus how much? Y2 minus Y1 of whole square. This is modulus of the given vector. Again, you can represent the unit vector in this case. In what manner? Unit vector r cap equal to how much? This is the del r divided how much? Modulus of r. This is nothing but the unit vector component as you have seen. Right? Then here, the magnitude of the displacement vector can be represented del r equal to x2 minus x1 plus y2 minus y1 respect to I cap and j cap. But students, on what factor the displacement vector depends? Displacement vector depends on only the initial position and final position, but does not depends on path followed by the particle. In what direction actually particle moving? The particle moving like this. In this path the particle moving. Are you following? In this direction. In this direction. This path may be greater than this way because simply I am taking the line joining. I mean, displacement vector does not depend on this path follower. Only depends on line joining from initial position to final position. No matter. I shall have one more example here. On how to take the displacement vector in a plane. Look at it. This is the one plane. Right? How the particle moves actually? The particle moves like this. In any manner the particle moves like this. I will choose any point, two points. See here. This is nothing but one point. Shall I call this is a P? And here one vector is there. This we are calling position vector R. Shall I choose? The one more point I will choose. This is nothing but P dash point. Right. Here one more vector. Shall I call this is the R dash? This is origin point O. Here how to represent displacement vector? Simply the line joining from initial position to final position. What about this? Del R I am calling. Del R vector. How to represent del R vector? Del R vector. Del r vector equal to how much? R dash minus r. In this case, what is the path followed by the particle? This is nothing but the path followed by the particle. This path may be greater than this distance. Simply, no matter what is the path followed by the particle. Then we are taking displacement vector is simply the difference between final position and initial position. Remember this point. This point is very important. After this coding, let us type. Already we know that vector should not be added by simple algebra. Vector add by special process. Now after this, let us see addition of vectors. Addition of vectors we'll see in detail. See here. Addition of vectors. Students, we know that the vector has both magnitude and direction. Due to direction of the vector should not be added by simple algebra. Then if two vectors are there for different position and different orientation, how to add the given vectors? See here, very simple. To add the given vector, actually three processes are there. One is a triangle of addition of vector, parallelogram of addition of vector, and third one is polygon of addition of vector. We'll see one by one process in detail. Generally, let us take two parallel vectors are there. Two parallel vectors of different of same magnitude. Shall I take here? I will take this another vector A. Vector A. Right? Let us take one more vector here. Look at here, one more vector shall I take? This is another vector B. Two parallel vectors are there, equal vectors are there. Then for this equal vector, how to represent addition? In between two vectors, there is no angle. Then how to represent here? The two vectors simply added by like this. Shall I show here? The resultant R equal to vector A plus vector B. What is R? R is the resultant vector, the sum of vector A and sum of vector B. I mean, if two vectors are in the same direction, they can add simply R equal to vector A plus vector B. Where vector R represents resultant vector. Now, shall I take the one more situation? See, here two equal vectors are there. What are resultant vector here? This is not even the resultant vector. That is represented by R. Right. Now, I will take collinear vectors. Collinear means different magnitude, same direction. Shall I take here? This is one vector A. I will take this is the one more vector. Shall I call? This vector is B. How to add these vectors? This vector can be added like this. Look at here. This vector can be added. How to add these vectors? This vector can be added. That is vector A plus vector B. Right? And the resultant can be taken in the direction of a greater magnitude vector. Which is the greater magnitude? This is the greater magnitude. Then what is the R direction again? R direction must be like this. Right? I mean, no matter. Smaller magnitude is there, here a greater magnitude is there. Resultant vector can be represented in the direction of greater magnitude. One more situation I will take. Now we will take unequal vectors. Unequal vectors or negative vectors I will take. See here. Here this is a vector A. Vector A I will take. One more vector I will take. What about this vector? This vector equal to minus B. Minus B. How to add these vectors? See if this vector can be added. How to add? This vector can be added. Vector R equal to how much? Vector R equal to vector A. Vector A of minus B vector. Right. Then what is the resultant? Shall I add the resultant vector in this manner? Vector R equal to how much? Vector A minus of vector B. Vector A minus of vector B. And how to show the resultant vector? Resultant vector is the direction along the greater magnitude vector. Shall I take this one? This one? Like this. Here, simple is that. If two vectors are in the same direction, simply add it. If two vectors are in opposite direction, simply subtract it. And how to take the direction? Direction can be taken along the greater magnitude vector. In this case, if two vectors are only in the same direction, but if two vectors are more than two vectors, if they are in opposite direction, how to add? It is very important. See here. I will take this is one vector. This is one vector. So let me take this vector. This vector represented by P. Now one more vector available. This is one more vector. Shall I put this vector? This vector equal to minus. This vector equal to Q. I mean, two vectors are inclined, some angle, with some angle. These two vectors how to act? It is very important. Students, this we are calling the tail of the vector. This we are calling head of the vector. To add this vector, let us choose any vector you can take. Either can take Q vector or P vector. How to add this vector? It is very important. See here. Shall I write how to add them? Simply, the P vector thus can be represented like this. This is the P vector. Now, to add this vector, the Q vector, tail of the Q vector brought in contact with the head of the P vector. This is the tail of the Q vector. How to add this? The tail of the vector Q, tail of the vector Q added to head of the vector P. Right? This is Q. What I did? Tail of the vector Q added to head of the vector. Then how to show the resultant? The resultant can be added by making line joining from tail to head. Tail to head, not from head to tail. How to add them? Look at them. Resultant, how would I? Resultant should be taken like this. Resultant. Like this. Right? Not resultant like this. I am going from tail to head. Not like this resultant. See here. How to take? Not like this. This is wrong. This is wrong. How to add? Simply from tail to head. Resultant. Tail to head. Then how to represent R? Vector R equal to. Vector R equal to vector Q, vector P plus vector Q. Vector P plus vector Q. Or when add this vector in alternative manner also. Not only P I am taking. Shall I take here? How to take? This is nothing but Q vector. Then how to add the P vector? Now P vector can be added like this. Tail of the vector P added to head of the vector Q. Shall I take this? Like this. Right? Here actually P plus Q is there. How to take the resultant? Resultant can be taken line joining from tail to head. Tail to head. Like this. This is nothing but resultant vector. R. How to represent R again? R equal to in this case what happened? R equal to in this case Q plus P. Q plus P. Then R is equal to P plus Q, R is equal to Q plus P. I mean, during addition of the vector, you can make any order. Either you can take A plus B or B plus A, doesn't matter. Because resultant remains same. R equal to P plus Q, here R equal to Q plus Q. This we are doing commutative law actually. As concerned to addition of vectors, we will see again in details in the next class. Thank you, students.